Hello everyone, good afternoon. Today is Sunday and here we are with our reflection of the weekend. And today we are going to talk about a very, very polemic topic. And the title of this topic is, are you really taking care of yourself? That's the question. That's the biggest title. And that's the idea of today, to start diving deep into the real meaning of self-care, because we hear a lot this word. We sometimes see this word in the media, in the platforms, everywhere. And what does it mean, self-care, really? Are you even aware of what it entails? Or right away, when you think about self-care, you realize a spa, something you want to buy, something you want to pamper yourself with, but that is material, that is external. The idea of today is going deep into those topics and start peeling the layers of how to take care of ourselves instead of the marketing or commercial version of how to take care of yourself. So the first questions to reflect upon that topic is, what are the signs and actions that you do to treat yourself right? And are you able to be with yourself? Are you able to really reflect by your own? Are you able to go outside and have your breakfast alone in a restaurant or in somewhere else? Are you able to go on a trip and travel by yourself and just be with yourself and see what is coming from that trip? Those are the things that we should be used to do and should cultivate more of doing them. Self-care starts by being able to accept you in the whole sense of the word, to know more about yourself, knowing the opportunities that probably you have had and you let them go because you didn't realize that your own value was not enough to retain all of those things that you already attracted at some point in your life. And that's how, or that's why, you lost them, or you sabotage yourself. You enter in those toxic cycles. Also, thinking about the ones, all the opportunities that now you want in your life to appear. So it's synchronizing yourself with the right frequency of thoughts in order to attract the things that you want. Not from the perspective of attaching your attention to the things that you don't want, because the first symptom of not being able to take care of yourself is denial. Denial of the things that you have done and start looking for excuses, people to blame, or any kind of external issue that drive you to do the things. No one or nothing can drive you to do anything that you don't want. So stop looking for excuses or for people to blame and start owning your life with the good and with the bad. Because that contrast that you have throughout your life is the one that allowed you to be where you are today. Who you are today is made from all of those experiences that you have been able to travel in your life. So now it is time to attach the right attention and intention to raise your frequency level, the vibrational level, the energy levels that you want in order to start becoming the magnet of the life that you care about. Every time we hear that word of self-care, we unconsciously start thinking of, what am I going to eat? What am I going to buy for myself? Where am I going to go to treat me well? Well, we start thinking about the things that are external to us. But I have never heard a person that says, I am going to treat myself well by meditating, or by journaling, or by reflecting in my life, or wanting to be alone, without noise, without distractions, without anything. It is very uncommon to hear people saying that the self-care measure that they want to implement in their lives is to be with themselves. And that's the whole point of the word. Self-care means being with you, means caring for you, but from your own perspective, from your own internal issues, from your own emotional trouble or emotional struggles or whatever it is that you have to fix within you. And that is the idea. Only when you stop and care about you and really giving self-care measures, you are going to become your higher version. The more you are attached to anything external, to giving you the best car, the best clothes, the best mobile device, the best whatever you want that is external, that's when you are losing all of the intention and the attention to what you really have to do. That is cultivating your inner world. Start knowing why you have had your life the way it has been unfolding in you throughout those years. Why did you lose some opportunities? Why did you lose that person that was really valuable for you? Because probably you didn't even realize that you deserve a good person in your life. Probably that's why the relationship didn't work, because you were not in the place of valuing yourself. So if you don't value yourself, it is not a match situation with a good person. And it is for sure that you are going to do something to sabotage the relationship and let the person go, justifying that something happened, that it was you, whatever it is, that she was or he was, whatever it is. Start to inventing or creating stories about the relationships and the conflicts, but the reality lies within you, lies the value that you have for yourself. And that value probably was polluted by all the toxicity that you were surrounded with in those circumstances, in that time. And that's why today I was reflecting about what happened in the US with the elections. I'm not going to talk about politics, but it is an important fact that happened. All this virus and pandemic state was the conditions that we needed as a society, and I'm talking about now the US, the society of US needed that time to reflect about the things that they wanted to change, about how they wanted to project, to reflect a different kind of government, a different kind of paradigm. So now there is hope that many things can change everywhere, not just in the US. This pandemic is for the whole world, and this year was given free to us to reflect. And if you also start thinking and analyzing the things that happened throughout this year, you were detached from the constant anxiety and need to get out and distract yourself, to spend money in things that you didn't really need, to do things that you were not in alignment with, to think more about your job and if it is the one that you want for the rest of your life or for some more years in your life. So all this time that we have given by this pandemic state is just how wise is nature and how grateful is nature with us and the universe and everything and all of those energy. They are giving us time to reflect, time to work in ourselves, time to really attach meaning to this word. Self-care, self-care, and I will repeat it one more time. Self-care means caring for you, means caring for your value within you, for all the struggles. If you have layers to peel, if you have conflicts from your own family, from the things that you witness, from the toxic examples that you saw by your father, by your mother, by whoever it is in your life. It is time to do that. It is a hard work. I'm not saying it is easy, but it is a work that you have to do at some point. And if you don't do it, if you don't really care about you, no one is gonna do it for you. So you are going to keep sabotaging yourself and putting the foot in your own way and falling again in the same spot. Just reflect about your life. Don't even attach so much projection to these things. Just do the reflection in your own life. That's what I'm doing with mine. I am reflecting about all the things that I have done, all the opportunities that probably I let go, and why did I let them go, and all the people that has been in my life that has crossed through my path, and what were the lessons. So that's the idea also for everyone. That is a self-care measure. That is doing the work and going into the layers. You will cry? Probably yes, you will cry. It will hurt? Yes, probably it will hurt. But in the end, you will become stronger. In the end, you will heal all of those wounds that are behind the layers that you created, the shields that you created to cope with the reality that sometimes is not the one that you wanted. Well, it is time. It is time to create the reality that you want. And the only way that you are going to create the reality that you want is by doing the inner work, the internal work. That's how we are going to do that healing process and that self-care measures. Thank you, Paul, for connecting. Thank you, Kerry, for connecting with the message. I'm really, really grateful for your attention. And I know that every one of us needs this kind of reflection. So if you help me to share this video with other people, I will really appreciate you for doing that. And just reflect about your life. Reflect about self-care measures, real self-care measures. Not spa, not a new car, not a new telephone, not anything material. Reflect about your own self-care measures. How do you want to love yourself? Love yourself. That's the word, love yourself. Love means going within, going through your own personal wounds and start detaching all of those things that are anchoring you to the limiting belief version. Release them. Release them. It's in your own power. The universe is just waiting for you to do the work so that you can receive everything. You cannot be ready or prepared to receive if you don't have space, if you are full of things that you don't want or that you don't accept or that you reject. That's the idea of today. Thank you very much for your attention. Have a wonderful Sunday afternoon and a wonderful beginning of the week. We'll see each other on Tuesday. Thank you. And if you want to read more and reflect more and do some exercises, there is a link of an article posted below. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful Sunday. Bye.